Pila crabs are perhaps one of sea angling's mystery baits. Lots of people have heard of them. Some people have tried and failed to use them. But there's a different procedure to get the best out of crabs. Now, when a crab, any crab this is, includes the edibles and lobsters and all those crustaceans want to grow, they have to grow a new shell under the old one and peel the old one off, a bit like a snake. What they do, they take on a lot of seawater, swell up the internal new shell and burst out of the old one, leave an empty carapace on the seabed. When they do this, the fish are obviously where it's happening. They do it in spring around much of the coast, but in some areas they do it all the year round. In those areas where the main molt happens in spring, they possibly all also peel in deep water away from the shore. But anyway, for most anglers, the spring brings a time when there's a glut of peeler crabs and they're plentiful. You can use them alive like these, or you can freeze them down for the winter. The common shore crab is found pretty well all around the coast, and its size, these are, I would say, on the small side. If you live in Scotland, you're used to getting big peelers. Down south where there's a big turnover of crabs, they tend to get smaller. Now, the time to use a peeler, not only is it when the fish are looking for it, they're inshore in spring, but also when it's ready to peel. When it's just about to shed its shell, it bursts out, all its internal organs, shell and everything is soft, and it oozes juice. We'll show you in a minute when we peel one. This juice has got tremendous pulling power and attracts fish from literally a mile, I would say. And they come inshore in the daylight, under cover of darkness, in search of crabs and have a feast. For the angler who wants to use peeler crabs, there are two options. Either he can collect his own, which entails a low tide trip amongst mud, round the groins, under rocks, that sort of thing, or he can buy it from the shop. Fairly expensive, and it fluctuates the price with the season and the availability of crabs. But a lot of people think, oh, it's a bit expensive. But of course, the good thing about crab is that it will keep for 2 weeks. So you've got a bait you can use in an instant, keep it in the fridge in some seaweed or a bit of hessian. The actual bait, you can use a whole crab, or you can use it in halves or quarters, and even the legs peel. Now, to find out whether crab's a peeler, if you're collecting your own, the easiest way is simply to take off the end of the leg segment. Just wriggle it and it pulls off easily, and you find a little tiny new leg underneath, same colour. If you just get white sinew, it's not a peeler crab. As I said, to get the best out of them, they want to be in ideal conditions. Now, when they start to shed the shell, you get a little hairline crack along the back, and as they take on water, they burst out. And when they're not quite ready to peel, they're fairly aggressive. You can see this one's fairly docile. But once they really start to get the peeler process going, because their internal skeletons and everything inside, well, their shell is their skeleton, but everything internal is soft, they haven't got much movement, they're a bit helpless, which is why they come inshore, creep up in a gully or up next to a groin, out of the way of everybody, and shed their shell, and then as their soft shell hardens, then they leave. So we want to use them when they're at that peak time and they're just about to pop out the shell. If it's too hard, all the internal organs are hard and there's no juices. Once it's well progressed into the peeling process, it's completely soft and juicy all over. And if you look at this one here, you'll see that its shell's starting to lift. Now that is prime. That's when they're ready to use. And this is one of the major failings with crab with anglers. They just get a bunch of crabs from the tackle deal or a bunch of crabs from the rocks and just use them willy-nilly. And what you've got to do is you've got to stage manage your stock of crab so that you can get them all just with their shell lifting. Now, if you buy 20 peeler crabs from the shop, you can only say, well, good chance you might have 4 or 5 ready to use. If you collect two dozen, three dozen from the shore, only a few will be usable. So you've got to stage manage them and bring them on, so to speak, so that they shed their shell when you want them to. That involves a fridge most of the time. You can keep the crabs in a polystyrene box and a bit of seaweed. And any sign of a hair crack, you can bring them out, put them in a small box, cover them with some wet newspaper, tissue, seaweed, anything just to keep them moist, and put them in the fridge. You'll find that putting them in the fridge and keeping them moist will tend to halt the process. The lower temperature stops them peeling. But you've also got to keep them moist, because if you don't, they dry out. So we use a bait spray to spray the crabs. Just to keep them moist. Once every couple of days, I do. And they take that moisture in, and that gradually splits the shell. The actual method of baiting the crab is pretty simple. Now, for large species like smoothhound, thornback ray, the crabs engulfed invariably whole. They don't really care about shell. But for the majority of the other fish, they tend to gobble the crab down and spit the shell out. So it's quite a practical way to present them, is to take the shell off, peel them if you like, so that you've got a soft jelly-like bait. Several ways of doing it. I mean, lots of people get squeamish about the crab, should I kill it? You can kill it with a knife, or you can cut it in half, which is one way. Cut it in half with a pair of scissors, and then peel it, and it's dead very quickly. I prefer, because I want to use a whole crab in this case, is just to quickly take the legs off and peel the shell quickly. And the crab is very quickly dead. Now, once you've peeled the crab, you want to present it on the hook with a minimum shell and things to interfere. The lungs and the shell, the edges of the shell, are quite hard. And if a piece of the shell gets onto the hook point, then it may well stop the hook penetrating the fish. So you be a bit fussy with them. Take all the shell off. It's fiddly, and your fingernails eventually get a bit of crab underneath, and you find it's quite painful. You want a long thumbnail. Anyway, once you've removed all the shell, there's several ways to bait them. Now, a big crab bait would involve a whole one like that, or maybe two even. It depends on what you're fishing for. If you're fishing for bass, perhaps you want two or three, or a big thornback, stingray, something like that, smoothhound, several crabs. But if you're only fishing for eels and flounders, perhaps a half a crab. So you've got to decide, and you've got to match the hook up to the bait that you're fishing with. So it's no good fishing with 2 3-0s for flounders, and it's not on to fish with a 1 for a thornback ray or a bass. So match the bait to the hook. Best way to bait a whole crab is to get your scissors and cut it nearly in half. What that does is allow you to open it out and spread it along the hook. There are various ways to bait. With a big bait like this, you don't have to be too fussy, because it's got to obviously be tied on the hook. Straight on like that. And a nice bit of elastic cotton. There's various types of cotton. You can get different strengths. You want to go for something that's fairly light and breaks easy, because once you remove the bait, after it's washed out, you want that be able to remove that cotton and start again. You don't want it to all be clogged up around the hook. Anyway, a few turns of cotton, fairly tight, and it breaks easy. Cotton container's handy, it stops it getting messy. As you can see, it's a messy business with crab. Now, you can also, with a peeler crab, you can also peel the claws and the legs. A good tester for crabs ready is whether you can break the claws. If you can't break the claws with your hands, then it's not really ready to peel. Anyway, section a claw on the hook. You can also do the same with the legs. Just add them to the bait. You no need to cover the hook point. In fact, it's best if it's exposed. Now, with the panel rig we've got here, we've got 2 hooks on this rig. We've got the main body of the crab in the main bottom hook, and we twist the line round this top hook and just knock it into the top of the bait. That keeps the bait in position, puts a hook at either end of the bait, and also if a big fish comes along, it invariably will catch that hook, a cod or a bass. All right. Now, that bait is perfect for most of the big species. You can make it a bit bigger. There's no problem there, because most of the species you're after, like bass and cod, have got a huge mouth, and the bigger bait will last longer. Sometimes the crabs will take their own, they'll eat their own, and they'll pester it. Other times it will stay there. It's a mystery to me why that happens, but it is the case. One of the things with crab, most baits, it's a good idea to discard the bait when you pull it back in after it's cast out for 20 minutes, 30 minutes, it's washed out. But with crab, you can give it a squeeze and perhaps add another side of crab to it, lash it on, and out you go again. And the scent of that bait is second to none. There's not another bait that will pull fish in from so far.